the eastern seaboard of the US. It's in these cities that the greatest American art of the 20th century was born. Just after the Second World War, a new form of all-American modern art came into being, and it gave the world some of the most exciting paintings of the entire 20th century, the work of Jackson Pollock or Mark Rothko. Their energy, their impact, are the qualities we associate with American modern art. And yet, it could all have been very different. American art in the 1930s mostly meant scenes of rural life and portraits. It was all about traditional values, parochial, conservative. So where did this bold new spirit of innovation come from? Well, the seeds were sown by a deeply tragic figure, a man whose name deserves to be much more widely known, Arshile Gorky. Gorky was an artist who became a kind of transatlantic pipeline for artistic ideas. He brought European modernism flowing into the US, and in doing so, he helped to create an entirely new modern American art. The Philadelphia Museum of Art has put together a Gorky retrospective to look again at his work. When you first walk into this exhibition, you think, some mistake, surely. Have I walked into the wrong show? Because here we've got a Cézanne painting of Aix-en-Provence. And here we've got a Cézanne still life. Here we've got a Cézanne watercolour. Is this really an exhibition of Arshile Gorky's paintings? Then you look at the label and you say, Staten Island. This isn't Aix-en-Provence. It's America. He was a man determined to master the styles of avant-garde painting. It's not an act of homage, it's not an act of pastiche, it's something much stranger and more unique than that. It's a form of pictorial ventriloquism. And it wasn't just Cézanne's style that Gorky, the artistic magpie, wanted for himself. He went on to Cubism and he became absolutely fascinated by the art of Picasso, determined to master Picasso's language too. And he was very clear that no artist, especially no artist in America, had any right to try and develop their own original style until they'd mastered the great styles that had been invented by the European avant-garde. Gorky was American art's wake-up call to what had been going on in Europe. His exotic good looks, that droopy moustache. He'd never even been to Paris, but the American artistic community began to look to him as a sort of enigmatic art guru, reshaping European avant-garde styles for the all-American scene. Now, this is one of my favourite pictures in the whole show. It's wonderful. It's a mural actually commissioned by Newark Airport. It's Gorky's celebration of air travel and America, and he's conceived the picture, in fact, as a kind of abstract map of America traversed by flight paths. Like many another American, Gorky was an immigrant. He'd come from the old world, but this was the new world, and if any nation deserved to have modern style, you know, the style of the European avant-garde, that nation was America. But I think it was Gorky's tragedy in the end that he never could quite forget his own rather dark past. Gorky was an Armenian immigrant. In 1920, he had left behind the aftermath of the genocide in Armenia. Over a million men, women, and children had been shot, butchered, or starved to death by the Turkish army. Gorky had survived. Some of those closest to him hadn't been so fortunate. Throughout his formative years, Gorky worked away obsessively at this image. He started it in 1926. He was still painting it in 1942, 16 years later. He couldn't leave it alone. I think it's an image that couldn't leave him alone either. It's a self-portrait. Here he is as a young boy, a teenager, and he's with his mother. And
his mother had died of starvation in his arms in Armenia, and this is the central tragedy of his life, something that he could never forget. And you can see it in his, there's something very haunted about his expression, and there's something very haunting about her expression. She looks out at you almost like an accusatory ghost. And in this picture, there's no sense of pastiche or homage to any other artist. It's as if the mask has dropped away, and this is the raw texture of Gorky's personal pain.
Gorky's past never let go of him, and yet it also drove his art forwards. He began to redeploy happier memories of rural Armenia through the artistic styles he'd mastered, as if to idealize the world of his past.
I think it's with this wonderfully vibrant, powerful picture that you can really sense that Gorky has found his own language, he's found himself, he's no longer a derivative artist. Now, at first sight, you might think this is another of those visions of his own Armenian past, another of those reinventions of his youth as a kind of paradise that it never truly was. But if you look more closely, you'll see there's something very bloody. There's a sense almost of some animal having had its entrails ripped out. Even in the Paradise Garden, at the centre of it all, there's a death.
Utopian yet dark, free yet precise, innovative and yet rooted in the past, if there seems to be something of the split personality about Gorky's art, it's no surprise. He constantly struggled for a sense of self-identity. Even the name Gorky was made up. He claimed he was the cousin of Russian writer Maxim Gorky. His real name was Vozdanig Adoyan. It was just one of many fibs and fantasies about his past. He was finally finding his artistic identity when he hit some bad luck that spiraled into tragedy.
There was a terrible studio fire in which much of his work was destroyed. A month after that, he was diagnosed with cancer. He turned to drink. He was involved in a car crash. His neck was broken. His ability to paint was deeply compromised. And if all of that wasn't bad enough, his wife left him. In 1947, he painted this picture, this harrowing picture, simply called Agony. A year after he painted it, in 1948, he committed suicide. Now, you might think that the experience of visiting this exhibition and living through the harrowing story of Gorky's life would be a rather depressing experience, but I don't think it is ultimately, because out of his ashes, a phoenix would rise. And partly because of the tragic circumstances of his life, Gorky became a kind of hero, a tragic hero to the generation of American artists who came after him. His work was truly discovered only after his death. He was the catalyst, if you like, for the great flowering of American art.